Hello everybody, welcome back to the Dead Mall series. In today's episode, we are going to be taking a look at the Lindale Mall in Cedar Rapids, Iowa, a perfect example of an open-air shopping plaza turned indoor mall. So you'll see some pictures coming up here of the mall when it was first constructed in the 60s and when it was originally an open-air plaza. And in this next picture, you see the mall when it was an open-air plaza compared to today, where it's all enclosed and Sears and Yonkers have closed and Von Maur has taken Killian's spot. So the mall was originally not going to be constructed. City officials didn't want that area to be rezoned as retail area. So in 1956, Sears and Yonkers kept announcing plans for the mall, and eventually city council allowed them to construct the Lindale Plaza, as it opened its name as. And it originally opened with Sears, Yonkers, and Killian's, and a open-air design. So right here is the backside of the Sears building, the customer service area and the auto center there on the left. And this Sears building is enormous. I mean, it is like half the size of the mall. So it takes a while to drive around it, but right there you can see the other side and an old picture from before it closed. So the Sears closed in 2018 when the company liquidated itself. You all know the story, so I won't bother explaining it. So the Lindale Plaza, as it was known, remained in outdoor shopping center throughout the 60s and 70s, and then in 1980 it was enclosed after the opening of Westdale Mall, a mall in southwest Cedar Rapids, a huge two-story four-anchor mall, which you'll see covered one day on this channel. But it was seen as the much nicer mall, and Lindale Mall was given a bad reputation. So coming around the west side of the mall here, you see the old Yonkers store and the label scar on it. And Yonkers closed their stores in 2018 alongside Sears when their company also went out of business. So 2018 was a bad year for this mall when it lost two of its biggest anchors. And right here you just see some old pictures of the Yonkers before it closed. So I entered through the western entrance on the lower level near the parking garage, right underneath the Yonkers. So the Yonkers would be above me, but this is a pretty much barren wasteland of a level. It has an old restaurant on the left there, another exit, it's sports trading shop, which is actually open, and then some kind of weird supermarket thingy, like a Kmart sort of. I don't know, it's a discount store, but it's closed permanently also. And then on the right here is a big wall. I'm not sure what that is exactly, but so you go up the escalator and then you enter the main concourse of the mall. And the plaza originally opened with early tenants like Kresge's and Eagle Supermarket and Bishop Buffet. And those were some of the other big, as they say them, anchors of the mall. Even though they weren't truly anchors, they were bigger stores in the mall. So every mall I've ever gone into has had this sense when you walk in of something that gives the mall personality, and I gotta say this mall is the clutterness of the mallway. I mean, here's the directory, but you'll see just how much stuff is in the way. Like, there are random pop machines, maps, these things with posters on them of old stadiums. And right here is an old shot of the open-air plaza and the Sears on the far end. So this is where I would be standing compared to today, where it's been enclosed. And if you look, it looks kind of like you can see the original open-air ceiling up there. And maybe not, but it just kind of looks like that with the lowered part of the ceiling. And then the higher part is where it was enclosed. And yeah, here's an example of all the crap in the middle of the mallway. And this is the center area. So I go down towards the food court, and the mall was actually pretty busy today, even though most of them were mall walkers, and the other half was people waiting out in the line for Bath & Body Works. So yeah, going down towards the food court, you'll see just how dead that area is. So one thing I love about walking up to the food court in this mall is the beautiful neon sign they have in the middle of the mallway on the ceiling. And I zoom in on it here for a second, but it's called the Terrace Food Court. Even though there's only about two stores open in the food court and the rest are empty, it was actually the home of where a violent fight broke out, and you'll see a news clip of that in just a second, but here's an example of all the empty food stalls.
Released the recordings today, and Fox 28 News reporter Brittany Borgie picked them up. Brittany?
Yeah, Scott, the phone calls paint the picture of a very frantic scene here at the Lindale Mall. There are a total of 9 calls, 8 with information, one where somebody just calls and hangs back up, but they were all made within 1 minute of each other, and then the fight is over.
911, severe emergency. Hello, 911.
911, Lindale Mall, food court, huge fight, chairs being thrown around. I'm not seeing a single cop in sight.
Okay, do you see any weapons?
Chairs. Just it's starting to calm down, and people are now dispersing. I can't believe there's not a security guard or anything. Well, somebody's got a gash in his head.
All right, we'll get somebody.
And he's walking out.
It was just 33 seconds after that first 911 call that dispatchers sent police to Lindale, while more calls came in.
Oh, this is at Lindale Mall food court. There's a fight in the food court. They're like throwing chairs at each other.
How many people?
It looks like 10 people.
There's a major fight at Cedar Rapids Mall, Lindale Mall. Okay. You need to get officers here right now.
Okay, sir. We're on our way.
Police got to the mall in 4 minutes. By that time, the fight was over, but people were still scared.
Okay, are they out in the parking lot now, or where are they?
Yes, they are. They're all over the place.
Cedar Rapids Police Department spokesperson Greg Bilo says while some were frustrated the cops weren't there faster,
I can't believe there's not a security guard or anything.
These calls are what got them there as quickly as possible and could have helped end the fight.
So yeah, right here you just see the food court and how empty it is. There's like one food stall open, the rest are empty. And there's a hoo-ha with a mall entrance, but there wasn't anybody going into there today. So a lot of the food stalls did leave after the incident of the fight broke out. And this mall was getting a bad reputation. And security was up because when the fight broke out, there was no security guards to respond to the fight. When I leave the food court here in a second, I walk back towards the center court, and then I start heading down towards the Sears wing right here. And I pass by the Von Maur right here, which I'm not sure why the mall entrance was closed, but it was gated off that day, and I didn't see anybody inside. Perhaps stores are still working on limited hours, but I'm not sure. The Sears wing is actually not doing too shabby. It has, like, some stores closed and some permanently closed, but it still sees a decent amount of traffic, but definitely not as much as this mall needs to keep it alive. So the Lindale Plaza was built by Bernard Greenbaum and Associates, and you might remember them from Merle Hay Mall in Des Moines because they both constructed these malls, hence the resemblances of them both being open-air plaza centers. And then Greenbaum later sold Lindale Mall to General Growth Properties. And General Growth Properties had just opened Town & Country Shopping Center 1.5 miles south in 1956, and it was kind of what pulled away a lot of shoppers originally from the mall. But the popularity of malls, them kind of starting to boom in the 60s and 70s, is what kind of gained this mall some traction. Right here you see the old Sears entrance, and seems like they've covered it up with a lot of stock photos and the black tile that the Sears originally had on the entrance was all written on by chalk. Back in the center court you see the water fountain, and that water fountain is actually really pretty, so it's definitely a sight to see if you ever come to this mall. So one thing you may notice when you're walking in this mall is the tile design on the floor, and I may be wrong, but my speculation is that that is a mall walker's walking track, hence the people on the left side right there are walking on it, and I am walking on it, and I didn't even realize it, but yeah, I'm pretty sure that's like the mall walking track, and that kind of circles around the whole mall, so that's pretty cool to see. This is the southern entrance to the mall. And a lot of stores on this end are closed. So I walk back towards the Yonkers, and then I go kind of down a similar entrance near the Yonkers. And right here, just a few pictures of the Yonkers before it closed, including the open air center at night, and more recent in 2010. So coming in where I first entered, do you see the old Yonkers and some of this stuff like I was talking about, all the stuff in the middle of the mallway, all the crap, and some really beautiful skylights. That's one thing this mall does really well in, is the amount of skylights it has. And here's the Yonkers entrance just after the mall was enclosed, compared to today where it's closed now, the Yonkers being. And then here's that small entrance area I was telling you about. And this end was really dead. There was no people here. So in just a second here, you'll see that bargain shop I was telling you about in the beginning of the episode. But yeah, that concludes today's episode of the Lindale Mall. In next week's episode, you'll see the South Park Mall in Moline, Illinois. And that's a special one because that one's extra dead. And you'll see. But I'll leave Paul Blart Mall Cop to lead me into my outro song, that being Detroit Rock City. But yeah. Until next time, have a lovely day, and peace out, guys. See you later.